My name is Thorsten von Overgaard. I'm a Danish photographer. I travel the world teaching photography and taking photographs. Today I'm going to talk about the Leica Q2. The Leica Q2 is a new camera that came out in February, March 2019. The history of the Leica Q2 is that Leica came out with a Leica Q in 2015, and that was a 24 megapixel camera. It was a huge success. It's been really, really difficult to get a Leica Q. If you walked into the store, they never had them in stock, you had to wait. So that was a big surprise for Leica, and people have been asking, can you make Leica Q with a 50 millimeter or 35 millimeter lens, because it comes with a 28 millimeter fixed lens. So 4 years after the first Leica Q came out, Leica came out with a Q2, and it still has exactly the same 28 1.7mm lens, but what it does have is that it has now a very big battery, it has 4K video, and it has a new EVF, improved EVF, so you see more if you wear eyeglasses like I do. The diopter here is put inside the body of the camera, and then it has simplified buttons. It has up here in the top, it doesn't have a video button anymore. The video is this one, you put into video mode and press the shutter release. Very nice and simple. And then it has one almost secret button here, and that is one that you press. When you press this one, it looks like a wheel, and it is a wheel. When you press this one, you get into the ISO setting and you can change the ISO and shoot away. Then it also have another almost secret button here. The first Q also had this one, and this one you change the frame line. The idea with changing the frame line is that you have a 28 millimeter lens on, but you can change the crop factor of the sensor, so you can have 35 or 50 millimeter lens. And this one has a 47 megapixel sensor, so now you can crop it also to 75 millimeter. So one little compact camera you can carry with you at all times, amazing design, very quiet, and you basically have a 28, 35, 50 and 75 millimeter lens in one camera. That's the main news in the Q. Most of the stuff is exactly the same as last time. It's a very popular, beautiful, simple camera. One thing you can see on the Q, but you can feel, if you're used to the Q and you get the Q, so you can feel this is better built. It's not that the original Q was not great built, it was a great Leica so-called handmade camera. What Leica have done with this one is they have ripped out everything inside to fit in a bigger battery, different sensor, 4K, and the cooling that you have to have with 4K video. Everything is basically the same, but the camera just feels much more sturdy and right. Which is a good thing, because Leica cameras traditionally are still being traded and used 10 years after they're made. So you buy this camera today, if you're not going to use it in 10 years, then somebody else is. So that's why it makes sense that this is really well built. Why is the Leica Q and the Leica Q2 such a great idea that everybody seemingly wants one, and everybody loves this camera and loves to use it? Well, it's a Leica, but what does it mean that it's a Leica? Well, the Leica philosophy or the idea with Leica is that things have to be simple, it has to be well made, it has to be handmade, it has to be the best optical quality you can get. And that is basically what you get in the Leica Q. You also get something else when you get a Leica Q, and that is you get immediately you get a craving for more Leica. And I don't know if that's a blessing or a curse, but there's lots of Leicas to be gotten. The most obvious thing is the Leica M system that you want, and you can even get it in different limited edition colors. This is something that is proven, that you get a Q, there's a very big chance that you want more Leica. And that's simply just because, I don't want to say awesome, that's like a bad word, but it is very essentially what photography is about. It's simple, it's well made, it's very high quality optical. That means like it's about photographs, so the photographs should look awesome, and they do. And part of the simplicity of a Leica is that you have here the light controls. You have here the aperture sits on the lens. The focus is autofocus, or you can switch it over to manual focus here. It has built-in macro here, so you can turn this. It has the shutter speed out here, so you can go manually. You can also go automatic or aperture parameter, it's called. So the camera helps you taking the photo. If you want to overrule it, you just turn this one. You don't have to go into a menu or anything. You can take one photo, you can take a series of photo. You can switch over, go video. If you want to change the ISO, which is the third light control setting, you just press this button and change it. If you want to control the colors, you press the FN button and you can change the white balance. And if you want to do any other settings that you don't really have to do when you take photos, but maybe more when you set up the camera, you can go into the menu. That is pretty simple compared to what else. And when I say simple, then a Leica menu usually have like 50 choices or something in total. Many other small consumer, easy, whatever, cameras have 750 choices. So that makes a big difference that you go into a menu for a camera. If you have to make 750 choices, a lot of them is things that you have never heard about, you have no idea what it is. Or you go to a Leica and you just have the bare minimum that you actually need. And you don't really need the menu a lot. You need to use the controls outside here. So it feels very much like if you're old enough that you have been photographing with a film camera in the 70s, which is like this one, then all the controls are exactly the same. This feels like a real camera, and that's one of the reasons that it's so popular. And it's a great camera to get for yourself. It's also a good one to borrow to friends, to family, to your spouse. They're going to be hooked on real photography, and it's just going to cost a lot of money, all the Leicas you need. But that's part of the feeling, or whatever it is you get with a Leica Q. The big news, or you could say almost the only real new thing in the Leica Q2, is the 47 megapixel sensor. So that's something that's going to make you wonder, do I need 47 megapixel, or what is 47 megapixels going to do for me, for my photograph, for anything? And there's only one way to find out, and that is to try it. And what I did is, when I got the Leica Q2, I actually felt, you know, you just want to take a test photo of a coffee cup or a flower or something. And I almost felt that I was wasting megapixels when I took the photo. I felt like I had each photo have to count. Then I went out with the camera for a whole day. So I walked around for like 6-7 hours with the camera and took a lot of photos. And one thing I noticed is when I take a photo, when I see the preview or when I see the photo in the viewfinder after, it's actually not that sharp. So I was a doubt, like, does my manual focus actually work? Does the autofocus, do I focus on the right thing? What is happening? So when I got home and I put it in the computer, I was actually blown away how much 47 megapixel means. There's so much detail in it, and it's not that the like a Q with 24 megapixel didn't have any details or anything, but 47 megapixel has a lot of details. And you could say, yeah, that's fascinating with 47 megapixels, but what's really fascinating is that it's the lens is built for this. This lens that is the same as on the original Leica Q for 24 megapixel is made for 100, 200 megapixel sensors or something like this. This is like an amazing lens, and you'll see, you zoom in, and not only do you see a lot of detail and they're sharp, but they're very alive. So it's not like some digitized sharpness or something. This is real optical sharpness recorded on a big sensor. That's the really interesting thing about it. When you get the 47 megapixel file and you get used to that, it's not actually wasting megapixels to take a photo of something that you don't know if it's going to be a good photo or not. You just take it because that's what you do now. But when you get home, you will see you need more computer power. 47 megapixel is big files. So if you sit and process 100 or 300 or something off it, it takes a while for the computer. It's a different workflow. And next thing you could say, well, maybe people don't like to be photographed the 47 megapixels with all the detail of the skin and the wrinkles, and if you have some dirt on the shirt, it's all there in 47 megapixel in every detail. So that's a thing also to consider. And then of course, why would you need 47 megapixel? I mean, if you take photos and you put them on Instagram or Facebook, or you send them by email, or you put them on a forum online, who cares if it's 47 megapixel? So this is a new line in photography, that you have 47 megapixel and you have a lens that can actually utilize it in a way you have never seen before. So that almost begs that you get a printer. I did. And you can make big prints, and this is actually one of the photos that I did. And suddenly when you start printing things, and especially if you print them big enough and you give prints to, like, you take photos of your friend's children or his dog or her dog, and you make some big prints and give it to them, suddenly it makes sense to have 47 megapixel. And it also makes sense, of course, in the way that one of the ideas that Leica introduced with the Q is that you can crop. So you have a 28 millimeter on the camera that is fixed, you cannot change it, but you can crop it to 35 or 50, and now in the Q2 to 75 millimeter. And that actually works. It even works that you go out and take photographs, and then when you get back, you kind of, maybe you remember, maybe you don't remember what exactly it was that you wanted to do, but now you have a 28 millimeter photo and you can actually crop whichever part of it, or you could just leave it like it is, or you could make a panorama. There's so much resolution, you can do anything with it. So that opens up for some new possibilities. I don't know if you need 47 megapixels. I think it's more a question that, given the choice between the Leica Q and the Leica Q2, it's probably really hard to resist getting the Q instead of the Q2. Even the Leica Q with 24 megapixels actually makes a lot of sense to have, because it's an awesome camera and the files are really easy to work with compared to this one. So that's something I cannot really advise about, but I can say that 47 megapixel with a Leica lens in front of it really opened my eyes for how interesting it is. It's also something that led me to get the Lumix with 47 megapixels, because I want to see how does it work with other Leica lenses. And 47 and more megapixels is something we're going to see more of in the Leica M11. The Leica SL Mark II that is coming in the future. Not the Leica M11 is not going to come anytime soon, but that's the direction it's going in. More megapixels, but not just for the sake of megapixels, but actually you have lenses that support the sensors and can capture the details in very lively and 3D. So that's the new thing about the Leica Q2, the really new thing and the only actual big difference between the Q2 and Leica Q. There's not much. When you get the Leica Q, you basically have packets. You need to know that it actually took me 2 weeks to find out that I now have a button here. I can change the ISO here. I was terrible annoyed that I had to go in the menu to change the ISO each time, and I found out I can actually press this one. I always change the strap. That's part of having a stylus camera, and especially a Leica, and also rangefinder and stuff, is that you change straps. You can see I have a lot of different ones, a yellow one, well, they're actually all kind of yellow. I have some silk straps here, so that's one of the fun things to just change it out. But one thing that's important with Leica Q is that you have a strap that is long enough. The one that comes from the factory is like this, so you can only hang here. It should hang across your chest like here, so you always have it ready, and it doesn't weigh a lot, and it's easy to get to, and you always have it with you. So I changed the strap, and like I have this old school rings here, and you can go online, you can buy a lot of leather straps, silk straps, all kinds of colors, big and small, different qualities. This is one that I started making myself, black with orange edged for the Leica Q to have like a simple strap. The Q also comes with a ventilated shade, or not a ventilated, comes with a shade like this. It's one that Leica made that you can say one thing is to protect the lens, the glass. You don't need a filter or something in front of this to protect it. It's very rare that anything would hit it. And this one covers the area so you don't have any light coming from outside that goes in and interfere with the picture. I didn't like this so much, so I actually make my own ventilator shades. And I made this one that is, ventilated. It doesn't have to be ventilated, but it's just because it looks cool. Ventilated idea is that in the old days of with rangefinder cameras like this one, you look through, out through this window. So here, the shade wouldn't cover, but that's not really a problem here because you have an electronic viewfinder. So this one I make, and I make them in red, and I made some new ones. There's like a matte one for the matte edition of the, like a QP. There's a green one just for the fun of it, a red one, and so on. So that's kind of like the things you can trick it off with. And you can also put on a hand grip on this one. And I actually have a hand grip here. Normally I don't like hand grips, but for the Q here, the Q2, I kind of like this hand grip for this one, and maybe because it's 47 megapixels that it feels like when you take a photo, you actually take a photo with a lot of detail. So maybe that's why I think that it's good to have a hand grip, but it's not something that you have to have. You can totally use the camera without. That's basically all there is to say about the Q. It's an awesome camera, and if you can't resist it, then you just have to get one. I've written a lot about the Leica Q on my website. There's a lot of advice how to shoot with 28mm, how to deal with editing, how to do this and that, how to do video with the camera, all sorts of things. And I've done the same with the Leica Q2, and I've also done a Leica Q and Leica Q2 video masterclass that will take you through how to use the camera at night, how to set the white balance, how to work with the camera and focus and do street photography and everything with it, and architecture. So that's something you can go to my website and look at more. The articles are free. My book and the video cost money. You can go to overgaard.dk and you can download the first, not the Leica Q book, but you can download a free book about photography for free. And then you can get my free newsletter in the future so we can stay connected. That's basically all I had to say about the Leica Q in this video. Hope to see you next time and have fun until then. And remember, always wear a camera.